Well, I can say this, it's more than sex. Way, 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 way more than that. And that's the goal. That's the game. That's the end game, you know, more than just my physicality being appeased or pleased or stimulated or titillated. It's more than that. You know, it's the rest of it. To have a partner that's on your team that will hold up their end, plus yours if you need it. That's what I'm talking about. There's a difference. Don't be scared of me. If you're scared of me, I will eat you.
Damn, Jill.
Okay, her place.
Damn.
I'm not kidding. So it's no point in me dating someone that's afraid of me, because I can walk all over you. And who wants that? Nobody wants that. I'll end up doing that and feel bad about it.
And leaving the person and they're crying.
And then you're like, I'm dating a bitch ass and I don't really,
why?
No respect.
Why?
They forget you from Philly sometimes.
I say it like this. If you can tell me what to do, then you can tell me what to do. But if you can't tell me what to do, you can't tell me what to do.
Damn.
Does that make sense?
I want to tweet that, but it ain't going to sound the same.
Picture sugar free a crash dummy. I ain't the smartest motherfucker in the world, but you just another bitch that need gas money. And this is some news you can use. Bitch, a million motherfuckers want to be in my shoes. Bitch, I'm a legend in these streets. The better kind. How many of y'all niggas know where y'all bitch at right now? Never mind. Believe everything that bitch tell you, huh? Don't lie to splurge. Boyfriend, pimping, nigga, shit, what is it? Mine or hers? Mo Baden. Your average nigga break his neck to go to your house. Have I ever been there? Okay then. What I'ma give a bitch a pass for? Spent all that time in school and got a job that ain't got nothing to do with you with your class for. Here goes some real sugar-free toughener. If the bitch got a gang of play cousins and play brothers, they fucking her. Sugar-free to pee. Look like the game hurt. If the bitch got two or three phones, she either a hoe or a brain surgeon.
How to write the book, motherfucker. I just read what was in the motherfucker.
I was watching a few clips. I think about two. I watched two clips of Jill Scott talking about how she is in relationships and whatnot, her relationship politics and shit. And I just, you know, it was kind of cringe, you know? It was cringe because what she said, I had been hearing since, you know, since I was around 18 or so, you know, well, maybe a little bit before that, maybe a lot before that, actually. But she was saying that, you know, if a guy's afraid of her, she's just going to run him over. You know, she's going to do what she wants, insinuating cheating as well. You know, just taking liberties with the man's self-respect, you know, and damaging and bruising him. She said that she would do that, you know. And I watched another clip where she was, you know, saying some garbage, right? And, you know, the reason I'm making this video today is, you know, for the teens, you know, of all ages, but mostly young guys, you know, guys in their formative, you know, adult years. You know, I want to tell you that when you hear a woman talking about her being handled or you can't handle her, that is a gigantic red flag, as you well know. Okay, I don't doubt that you don't know that shit, but, you know, a lot of women, as we know, the majority of our women, survive on validation and shit, external validation and shit, not particularly from their romantic partners or, you know, lovers, okay? They need that from all areas of their life and shit. That's why they glue themselves to social media and shit and just exist in that bullshit, you know, in the matrix and whatnot. But yeah, I heard Jill Scott talking about this shit, and basically what she's saying is that she wants to be treated a certain way. She wants to be, well, you know, I guess treated like garbage. There's no way I can look at it and shit. It's the same ideology, you know, or the, you know, reason for, you know, all of those black women on the Ghetto Gaggers website shit over the years. You know, they continue to go there, okay? Mostly dark-skinned black women, you know, a couple of red bones in there. But they continue to go there shit because it's part of their indoctrination and shit to be combative, you know? Not to be able to pair bond and shit, and that try to undermine you and to destroy your credibility and your name. You know, I hate to say this, you know, I love her music. I'm gonna love her music after I make this commentary and shit, but her talk game is garbage and shit, and I wouldn't have nothing to do with her. Okay, she's already shown that, you know, she's a member of Hollyweird, specifically Black Hollyweird, and had some antics of her own. I like to preface with this with saying I enjoyed her on in some of the projects that she's been in. I saw her in that Black Lightning show playing a crime boss, and it fit her like a glove, you know. Fit her like a glove. She actually, you know, radiated a dangerous aura. And we see that's just a sliver of her actual personality, okay? You know, I liked her. I liked her since she came out, but, you know, I hate her talk game, and I hate her. If this is who she is as a person, she's garbage, okay? When a woman tells you you don't know how to handle her, you handle her by getting up and walking the fuck away, okay? Get up and walk the fuck away with no explanation. That bitch is going to be chasing your ass till the cows come home and shit. She's going to do anything to find out why you just got up and walked away without saying a word. And don't look back. I ain't going about your business. Just, you know, keep it moving. Kick the can. You know, kick rocks and shit, okay? Right? You're not on this earth to be someone's handler and shit, okay? This woman is a celebrity. She's used to having handlers and people telling her where to go and what to do and shit. Not necessarily what to say, apparently, because this damaged her credibility. This is woman is renowned across the world for her singing ability and shit. She just basically ghetto. She's ghetto. She wants you to treat like an animal, you know? Have sex with her like an animal. Probably bang her out, you know? And treat like garbage, man. You roll up in a ball and towel drive her and shit, you know? I hate to be so crass. But a lot of women that I, you know, in my personal life saying that shit, especially some of these big mamas, you know, Big Keisha and shit, you know, it was always a sexual innuendo. You know, I've had women get in my face and get past my, you know, my boundaries and shit, you know, push on my boundaries, get real close and say that shit. And it was always about some kind of, you know, physical altercation between us and shit. All right? I'm not going to go no further, but, you know, when you hear a female talking about, you can't handle this and shit, you agree with her silently, turn the fuck around, walk away, don't look back. That's the best way to handle her, okay? Best way to handle her. Talk game is trash, you know? Hey, Jill, they love them tickle bitties and shit, man, but, you know, and that baby face of yours, but, you know, basically, you know, all I really have to say is, Kings, keep your head on a swivel. Protect your bag. Even if she makes more than you and has a certain status, and above all else, do not make broken and fallen women the stewards of your family, your children, and your protect your seed. This shit, you know, that's your legacy, your future. Okay, SYSBM equals save yourself, Black man.
This message has been paid for by the Dusties. Yes, the niggas you love to hate.